ladies and gents, I've a song ready made, and to sing it I'm sure you will not be afraid. For I'll tell you, once I'm a weaver by trade. So sing success to the weavers, the weavers forever, huzzah. Here are goods every day we're exporting by bills, and in merchandise ours as an art never fails. For each ship leaving port owes the weaver for sales. So sing success to the weavers, the weavers forever, huzzah. The queen in her robes may so gracefully stand, and her nobles about her may look great and grand. Till they get all their cloth by the work of our hand. So sing success to the weavers, the weavers forever, huzzah. But for us, how your soldiers would often repent, when houseless to sleep on their knapsacks they're sent. But the weaver, you see, gives each soldier his tent. So sing success to the weavers, the weavers forever, huzzah. If exhausted you feel, and by mobius you beat, in the heat or the cold, a small rest would be sweet. Then think of the weaver's fine blanket and sheet. So sing success to the weavers, the weavers forever, huzzah. The ladies are pretty, as all will confess, any stupid or blind, I am sure, who says less. But then to the weavers they're indebted for dress. So sing success to the weavers, the weavers forever, huzzah. Then since we from mankind are sent here to weave, for our looms and our shuttles we'll not idly grieve. My song is just ending, so I'll take my leave. Sing success to the weavers, the weavers forever, huzzah.
In a motor car, 60 bobbies are after us and we don't know where we are. Oh, we're off, we're off, we're off in a motor car, 60 bobbies are after us and we don't know where we are.
And we're standing on the corner eating apple pie. A policeman asked for a skinny bit and I poked him in the eye. He went and told me mother wouldn't come. I went and got a lollipop and stuck it up his bum. Oh, we're off, we're off, we're off in a motor car. 60 bobbies are after us and we don't know where we are. Oh, we're off, we're off, we're off in a motor car. 60 bobbies are after us and we don't know where we are.
Night were dark and stormy, rain fell down in lumps. Tram were on its journey from Mullinwood to Mumps. A dog run in the tram lines, driver rang his bell. Dog didn't hear the signal, so he's on his way to Halifax.
We're off, we're off, we're off in a motor car. 60 bobbies are after us and we don't know where we are. Oh, we're off, we're off, we're off in a motor car. 60 bobbies are after us and we don't know where we are. My father was an hero, his bravery made me blush. They were giving free beer up at Roebuck, and my dad got killed in Crush.
Oh, we're off, we're off, we're off in a motor car. 60 bobbies are after us and we don't know where we are. Oh, we're off, we're off, we're off in a motor car. 60 bobbies are after us and we don't know where we are.
Beavers, bulldogs sitting on a wall, selling or smoke penny a ball.
wife, and her name it is Nell. She's always screaming and bawling. £18 of a pension I get in a year. It causes me wife to drink whiskey and beer, and her voice like a cannon does sound in me. Before the daylight in the morning, her beauty and praises I mean to disclose. She's short, fat and ugly with a big stuffy nose, a disgrace to all women wherever she goes. And her clothes all in tatters are hanging. I've travelled through Germany, France and through Spain, through Egypt and India and back home again. At Waterloo wounded where I felt great pain. But I ne'er met the match of me, darling. To finish me ditty, I firmly do pray that afore she does either drink whiskey or tea, summat or other I'll whip her away. Before the daylight in the morning.
Come all you sons of toil, listen to my song, whilst I the tale unfold all brief and wrong. It was in 48 when work was scant, our wages were reduced 10%. Our masters pledged to pay should trade revive. The 10% they took, the panic to survive. But now the trade is good again, our wants we have made known. But our employers tell us we must let well alone. Since they will not comply with our just demand, we have resolved to bring the mills to a stand. Since we the losses of bad trade must bear, why not in prosperous times have our just share? Truth is on our side, with cheering ray, help us then, fellow men, to win the day.
I'm welly off me chump, I scrap and wash and down. Our children on an holiday and houses like a band. You talk about an home sweet home, me peace has flown away. I have to live in bedlam for a fortnight and a day. They're in and out from morn till night. I might well look so sour. They're wanting pennies every day and butties every hour. They've worn this Sunday carpet out. We're walking up and down. Our Jimmy broke a jug today and Polly broke her crown. Our Bill, who has a biggish mouth, is always in disgrace. He set off coughing t'other night and went right black in face. He swallowed Bobby's dummy tip, we're arranging we are bet. We've given him tons of physic, but we are not found it yet. Our Bobby's been in bed a day, poor laddie does look hurt. He went to swimming yesterday and Sunday stole his shirt. Our Jack's a plaster on his nose, poor beggar looks a treat. He pulled his tongue out to a lad who lives in Stormy Street. I've clouted him and slapped him till my hands and arms are sore. As fancy I'm in paradise when holidays are o'er. They're like a lot of lunatics, them getting out of hand. But yet I would not part with them for all there is in land.
When I was a lad, well, a street was a street full of kids, paper planes reeked of tar in the heat. At night, gas lights shone on cracked cobbles below. Oh, the town I have known, she is changing her cloak, is the owl to become a flamingo. Now street lights like monsters cast a bright orange hue on the shiny black surface, now common yet new. And the streets are all empty, no neighbouring now. For the town I have known, she is changing her cloak, is the owl to become a flamingo. Oh, the plain stone floor alehouse is saying goodbye. Foam, rubber and plastic are well on the way. And many a mill worker speaks oh so, so. For the town I have known, she is changing her cloak, is the owl to become a flamingo. No rubber boot hides in the still of sunbrew. Man-made gulfs in our town are to make the place new. Giant cranes even make our mill chimneys look low. For the town I have known, she is changing her cloak, is the owl to become a flamingo. Let's get rid of Cranjway, how could that be a loss? Give me back the white horse, the canteen and the oars. Give me back the tradition that bulldozed below. For the town I have known, she is changing her cloak. Is the owl to become a flamingo?
To Rochdale Mashers, we often go out on the mash. We wear no tall hats and no shirts to our backs, and it's seldom we have any cash. We always bring out the new fashions, while others they stick to the old. And though we are just 27, we are handsome, stout-hearted and bold. And we'll sing tra-la-la-la-la as we walk down the street. For style and perfection we ne'er can be beat. All the ladies declare that we are a treat. We're the two Rochdale Mashers from off Yorkshire Street. And we'll dance and we'll sing, we don't give a jot. We're a jolly fine lot. We're all right when we're tight, and we're jolly fine company. Last Saturday we were invited to the Roebuck by two ladies fair. Their cheeks were in bloom like the roses in June, as we danced with that beautiful pair. There was dancing and singing till midnight. We had whiskey, tobacco and rum. And after the dancing was over, with those ladies we had lots of fun. For we'll sing tra-la-la-la-la as we walk down the street. For style and perfection we ne'er can be beat. All the ladies declare that we are a treat. We're the two Rochdale Mashers from off Yorkshire Street. And we'll dance and we'll sing, and we don't give a jot. We're a jolly fine lot. We're all right when we're tight, and we're jolly fine company.
Other day, and he spied a fair damsel, and to her did say, tell me, dear, whose piglins are them in yon sty? They belong to Thout Souser, the girl made reply. Oh, you're very sharp-witted, the Lord then did say, then by the same rule who may own you, I pray. My mother, she said, with a smile on her cheek, but Jimmy and Nancy, I'll claim me next week. Who's Jimmy and Nancy? The nobleman said, Is he some wealthy squire, a gentleman bred? Oh, he's no wealthy squire, the maiden said she, for his top lad and Nancy and his skins in one ear. Why do you prefer one that squints? The Lord said, 'cause one that see straight has less use for his yed, and one that sees o'er two fences at once can mind two folks' business, or else he's a dunce. Well, answered young maiden, the Lord then said he, there's an int in me meddling I plainly can see. Now what can I give you, your favours to gain? Give me sight of your back, said the maid with disdain. Well, a week after this, saw the couple at church. They were met with the Lord as they entered the porch, and he promised them then that when twins blessed their lot, a good acre of land he would add to their plot. Just 9 months after this, the young couple were blessed, and child in his cradle lay sucking his fist. And then the good maid thus accosted the Lord, it matter a twins, will you stick to your word? But I only see one, said the Lord with a smile, and he took the young babby from his cot for a while. Oh, you're done for, said maid, lest you promise you rue, you may not but see one, but our Jimmy see.
Three Pennine Rangers went up to Thut. The beans were on the primus, all covered with soot. One Pennine Ranger went to shut the door. The beans fell off the primus and covered the floor. Three Pennine Rangers looking very sad. One said to t'other, "Eh, my lad, that's bad. There goes our supper, sustaining and supreme. For how can a ranger exist without his beans?" Then in the distance, coming very quick, came a Pennine Ranger, and in his hand a stick. And in t'other, what do you think was seen? You're right, first time, my lads, a dozen tins of beans. Soon the Pennine Rangers were sat down to a feed. Each the other's capacity was trying to exceed. When they had finished, they couldn't get through the door, so they had to spend the night with the beans upon the floor. And if you'll take my advice, you'll eat your beans stone cold without a spoon.
Two Jews and they came from Jerusalem.
Glory, hallelujah, they're on Jerome.
And one were rich and told there were a porium.
Glory, hallelujah, they're on Jerome. Air on Jerome, air on Jerome. Skin of a Spanish onion, oh, what a funny and. Glory, hallelujah, air on Jerome.
The poor Jew died and he went up to heaven.
Glory, alleluia, here on Jerome.
He had his supper with the saints at a 11:15.
Glory, alleluia, here on Jerome. Here on Jerome, here on Jerome. Skin of a Spanish onion, oh what a funny un. Glory, alleluia, hey Roger on.
The rich Jew died and he didn't fare so well, he un.
Glory, alleluia, hey Roger on.
He took a little journey all the way down to Allium.
Glory, alleluia, hey Roger on. Hey Roger on. Skin of a Spanish onion, oh what a funny un. Glory, alleluia, hey Roger on.
He asked out Nick for a whiskey and a sodium.
Glory, alleluia, hey Roger on.
And out Nick told him to shovel on the coleum.
Glory, alleluia, hey Roger on. Hey Roger on. Hey Roger on. Skin of a Spanish onion, oh what a funny brella. Hey Roger on.
To this story that's all the scriptures tell.
Glory, alleluia, hey Roger on.
And if you want any more you can sing it for your cellion.
Glory, alleluia, hey Roger on. Hey Roger on. Hey Roger on. Skin of a Spanish onion, oh what a funny un. Glory, alleluia, hey Roger on.
Good master, let a little child pieceer in your factory. From early morn to dewy eve, relate a simple history. Before I came to work for you, my heart was full of mirth and glee. I played and laughed and ran about. No kitten was so blithe as me. When at the age of 6 years old, poor mother pressed with want and woe, took me one morning by the hand and set to the factory down the school. They thrust me in and shut the door, midst rattling wheels and noisy din. And in the frame gate made me stand to learn the trade of piecing. I often hurt my little hands and made my tender fingers bleed. When piecing threads and stopping flies, and I thought was hard indeed. The overlooker passed me off, and when he cried down there, my little heart did tremble so, I almost fell with fear. When at the weary's evening's close, I could not keep myself awake. He sometimes strapped me till I cried, as if my little heart would break. Master, did you know the half that we endured to gain you gold? Your heart might tremble for the day when that sad tale must be told. They say that you grow very rich by little pieces such as me, that you're going to Parliament to guard our laws and liberty. Oh, when you're there, remember. remember us while at your friends we labour still, and give your best support and aid to Saddler's Tanner's Bill.
A miller were he in Lancashire born and bred, a mill where all he depended upon to earn him his daily bread. How Jeremy he were growing, how this latter end were near. He had three sons, it troubled him sore which of them would be his heir. He called to him his eldest son, an answer give to me. What way that take the bread to make if me mill were given to thee? Oh, if the mill were mine, said he, I'll plainly tell to you. Out of every sack I'd take a peck as you've been used to do. He called to him his second son, an answer give to me. What way that take the bread to make if me mill were given to thee? Oh, if the mill were mine, said he, you're sure as me name is Rafe. Instead of a peck out of every sack, I'm sure I'd take an if. He called to him his youngest son, his youngest lad were Will. On th' answer thou dost give to me depends who gets me mill. Oh, if the mill were mine, said he, a living I would make. Instead of an if, I'd take all lot and cheat him out at sack. How Jeremy he sat up in bed to hear him talk so smart. Said, well done, Will, that's won me mill, that lad after my own heart. And t'other two looked rather blue and swore it were too bad. But little Will, he won the mill and the divil he got his dad.
This world's just like a ranty pool, it's nowt but ups and downs. I've found it mostly down, miss, and I'm used to fortune's frowns. Our folk were all tarred with same brush, they were either bad or wicked. I were the only one as were any good folk reckoned when they bickered. Oh, me granddad stood on marketplace selling pigeons fine and sleek. When let loose they go flying, woman he'd sell them again next week. Me uncle Sam played big bassoon, but it didn't suit Aunt Jane. So who clouted him, what yet we used to get music on the brain. Oh, me mother had a rare complaint, they call it beg and borrow. From next door who catch Sunday joints and I'll fetch it back tomorrow. Uncle Eli were a card sharper, cards up his sleeve he hood. One day they caught him at his tricks and trumped his ace for good. Oh, Our Billy were as cute and fouse as a barrel full of apes. He'd shave whiskers off his goose gob's eye and sell them you as grapes. Hard work didn't seem to suit him, boy, he said it made him thin. First day he worked, he'd an accident, sprained his wrist with clocking in. Oh, I could keep you here till cows come warm, telling of me family's woes. But that wouldn't alter things, I guess, for they're all as black as crows. They all went down, you lads, you've heard them on the bin, no bread. I'm the only one as were any good, at least that's what folks said. Oh, although they reckoned me best at bunch, well I didn't take heed at warning. That's why I'm sitting in this cell, they're hanging me in mourning. I've been to Spain, but never again. I wouldn't go there twice. I said, me name's John Willie. They said it sounded silly. They wouldn't call me that at any price. They soon made me change me name. And a real proper Spaniard I became.
Don Pedro, the great bullfighting hero, the Lancashire Toreador.
Well, they cheered me, and when the bull gets near me, to show how far a brave monk can go, with the bull I dance the tango. Then when I hung on his tail, my pants he tried to gore. I started rushing around the ring with bull giving chase. Three times he tossed me in the air, I looked at his grace. They shouted, look at all that skin and bone round the place.
It's the Lancashire Toreador. Don Pedro, the great bullfighting hero, the Lancashire Toreador.
I met her, charming senoretta. For to love me you can never, then kiss me goodbye forever. That night, as she retired, she locked her bedroom door. She started to undress and timidly she looked round. She said, thank God I'm rid of him, now he's homeward bound. But when she pulled the bedclothes down, now guess what she found?
The Lancashire Toreador. Don Pedro, the great bullfighting hero, the Lancashire Toreador.
Well, I scared him, no mercy ever spared him. In the dead of night I ramble, Spanish castle walls I scramble. I saw a shadow above, a girl in her boudoir. I started climbing balcony, it started for its sway. She shouted, murder, there's a bandit, spur my life, pray. But when me castanets I rackle, she said, hurry!
It's the Lancashire Toreador, Lancashire Toreador, Lancashire Toreador. Woo!
All in this pleasant evening together come are we, for the summer springs so fresh, green and gay. We'll tell you of a blossom that buds on every tree, growing near to the merry month of May. Rise up, the the master of this house. Put on your chain of gold, for the summer springs so fresh, green and gay. We hope you're not offended, your house we make so bold, drawing near to the merry month of May.
Rise up, the mistress of this house, with gold upon your breast,
for the summer springs so fresh, green and gay.
And if your body be asleep, I hope your soul's at rest,
drawing near to the merry month of May.
Rise up, the children of this house, all in your rich attire,
for the summer springs so fresh, green and gay.
For every hair upon your head shines like the silver wire,
drawing near to the merry month of May. God bless this house and harbour, your riches and your store, for the summer springs so fresh, green and gay. We hope the Lord will prosper you, both now and evermore, drawing near to the merry month of May. So now we're going to leave you in peace and plenty here, for the summer springs so fresh, green and gay. We shall not sing you May again until another year, for to draw you these cold winters away.
In a cowboy picture once, I saw an horse get steaming drunk. They say that in America, there's a man who tamed a skunk. You can go to the Bahamas, Casablanca or Beirut, but you'll find out there, as can compare with John Willis performing Newt.
What a belter, what a dancer, though he couldn't sing a word he's mute. He can dance the slippers off a centipede, John Willis performing Newt.
A brilliant escapologist, this rare amphibian being, this dreadnought eft performs some feats that kings have enjoyed seeing. He riddles o'er a red-hot grate with glowing coals and logs on, but never once has he singed his feet, he always keeps his clogs on.
What a belter, what a dancer, though he couldn't sing a word he's mute. He can dance the slippers off a centipede, John Willis performing Newt.
Cadets, they call him Pistaza and prefer him to the bull. When he dances to flamenco, he the deadly Spanish lull. As he riddles to the rhythm of the drum, guitar and lute, the senoritas, they shout, bravo!
John Willis performing.
What a belter, what a dancer, though he couldn't sing a word he's mute. He can dance the slippers off a centipede, John Willis performing Newt.
He performed before John Wayne one day, you should have seen him buzz. When Towdy come from Oldham, Big John said,
the hell he does.
He should have been born in Texas. Such a talented galoot. This a rootin' tootin' son of a gun, John Willis performing mute. What a belter, what a dancer. Though he couldn't sing a word, he's mused. He can dance the slippers of a centipede, John Willis performing mute. What a belter, what a dancer. Though he couldn't sing a word, he's mused. He can dance the slippers off a centipede, John Willis performing nudes. William and folk around here calls me William, cause that is me name. I work on a farm every month of the year and each day of the week just the same. But I've fallen in love with a buxom fine wench and I think she's a fancy for me. Cause only last evening we sat on a bench underneath the arm sycamore tree. And we got at one another and never said nout about how she went a-walking with me, you know, down through the fields where the turmeets grow. We sat out in hands for an hour or so and never said nout about how. To dance down at Farmer Giles' barn, so I went in my best velvet corns. Although I'm the dancer, I'm willing to learn how to clump with me clogs on the boards. Now Betty was there and she looked at her treat like a blooming geranium. And when she said, William, that's geeting big feet, but I'll dance with the hours struck dumb. And we got to one another and never said nout about out. She cuddled up closer, I felt so queer. I wish that nobody else were near, cause I wanted to bite a lump out of her ear, but never said nout about out. Top in her, tail in her, ditch in her, railing, I think of her all the day through. I'm feeling that spoony, I'm going quite loony, she fur makes me riddle, she do. Or whether I'm ploughing or driving the cow in, I think's when I'll meet her again. Last night I said, Betty, if mother'll let you come out for a walk in the lane. And we got one another and never said nout about out. She looked at me sloppy like full of love and cuddled up close like a turtle dove. She looked that there soft, I gave her a shove and never said nout about out. But just at that moment the moon worried and into me arms we a bump she slid. I'm not gonna tell you just what I did, but I never said nout about out, about out, about out. I never said nout.
When I was one, I ate a scone going out to sea. I jumped aboard a pirate ship and the captain said to me, we're going over, oopsie, under, stand at attention, stand at ease, so the captain, bend your knees.
I had a bloater and it was double jointed. I give it to another girl and she was disappointed. My word, Edie, I'll tell your father for kissing Ivy Inchcliffe round yon corner. How many kisses did he give you?
Peppers.
Ickle ockle chocolate bottle, ickle ockle out. Turn the dirty dishcloth inside out.
When I was two, I buckled my shoe going out to sea. I jumped aboard a pirate ship and the captain said to me, we're going over, oopsie,
under, stand at attention,
stand at ease.
So the captain
bend your knees.
Quick, quick, the cat's been sick. Whir, whir, under chair. Hurry, hurry, fetch the jury. No, no, fetch the bow. Kate, Kate, you're far too late. Carpet's in a dreadful state.
How many crows can you pick from your nose in an English country garden? You pick 'em and you lick 'em and you roll 'em and you flick 'em in an English country garden.
I was three, I lost me key going out to sea. I jumped aboard a pirate ship and the captain said to me, we're going over,
oopsie,
under,
stand at attention,
stand at ease.
So the captain
bend your knees.
Stick it.
What way?
Jam.
How can I manage it?
The best way you can.
Never let your ding-dong dangle in the dirt. Always keep your ding-dong wrapped up in your shirt.
When I was four, my feet were sore, blowing out to sea. I jumped aboard a pirate ship and the captain said to me, we're going
over,
oopsie,
under,
stand at attention,
stand at ease.
So,
the captain,
bend your knees.
Bells, Batman smells, Robin's on his way. Father Christmas lost his trousers on the Milky Way.
Once an angel said to me, would you like a cup of tea? I said, no, Joe, I like cocoa better than tea. John, get up and light the fire. Turn the gas a little bit higher. Go and tell your Aunt Mariah Bobby's got a
South Street, where I was brought up's coming down, and the house I lived in crumbling. Lintels sag as if they frown. That Sylvia father sharpened knives is cracked. Yon steppers gleamed with donkey stone, with mildew is attacked. They're smashing up our memories, it seems, and through what used to be our roof are blowing childhood dreams. Blank windows stir as if in mute protest that man won't stand on stool again and clean them with dad's vest. Is that same window where I once looked down and cheered them hunger marchers on their trek to London town? Can that bit same front door I thump like mad and yell through the iron letterbox, school board man's coming, Dad! There's rusty nail where our tin bath once swung, and thookin't wall where clothesline went, where nappies all as hung. Can that bit voice of Mrs. Dunn I hear, chastising husband Jemmy, sleeping off his Sunday beer? Or were it simply wind having a sigh, as if it could be mourning for a house about to die?
about your Yankee jazz bands. Talk about your Sousa's brass bands. I've got a band, it's the finest in the land. It's a jazz, it's a jazz, it's a jazz. Talk about your ragtime one step. Talk about your up cross bun steps. I'm up when I get up on the spot. With me jazz, itchy coo. Doodaloo, same to you. And likewise, cock-a-doodle-doo. Oh, oh, that Lancashire jazz band. Oh, oh, by Gonji, with his grand. When I start, you bet there's something doing. Folks all say the time the plumper's ruined. When they hear me start to play any rags, any bottles today, when like this I start to sway. Everybody thinks I'm kind. The girls and dogs all follow me for miles, and our tongue sunny boy from Bootle. When the ladies hear me tootle, they give a sigh and they look at me and cry. It's a burr, it's a burr, it's a burr. When I play me rag sonatas, everybody throws tomatoes. By gum, I'm a devil on the drum. With me jazz, I'm the goods. It's the biz, yes it is. Yaka kiki down gee way. Oh, that Lancashire jazz band. Oh, say kiddo, it's just grand. See this fell from the wind. Bang that drum, by gum, it is a big un. I'm the real guy when I play any rags. Any bottles today, when like this I start to sway. Everybody thinks I'm calm. When I play on me coin, it the Swanee River flows. Folks all think I'm trying to blow me nose. When they hear, when they hear me Lancashire jazz band.
He jazz, he like it.
On what the Rosedale's that when it's at home?
Jazz, jazz.
Jazz, do you like that?
I do.
Oh, I don't. I'd rather have some proper music, me.
What's that?
Something that hits me right there, undershirt, right in the heart. Something with some tradition and history and patriotism.
Do you mean something like Mother Hold the Candle While I Shave the Chicken's Leg?
No, not that one. That one, you know, about Kiss Me Hardy and all that. I know a belter.
What's it called?
Called, "'Twas in Trafalgar's Bay."
Oh, I know that one.
Yeah?
I do.
Well,
well, let me do it my way.
Okay.
Eh?
Right.
Oh, 'twas in Trafalgar's Bay. Oh, oh, we saw the Frenchmen lay. Every heart was beating like a good un. When we found their ships were only wooden, then I heard Lord Nelson say, expect
began to fly. That's our poor old Nelson lost his eye. And he roared overboard with your Lancashire jazz band.
I heard a lark in flight and song, and I looked and listened as I walked along. I asked her what vision inspired a sweet lilt in terrain hardly barren and hardly yet built, and she told me what she sang of. She sang of a river, though barely a stream, by which bluebells and heather and wimberry teem. Near an old mill where trout are there to be seen, amid banks that boast myriads of yellows and greens, and folk come with guns to shoot heron. My songstress, she sang of the village of Delph, with a tune so enchanting I warble myself, of dwellings so rustic and pastorally calm, so contented, so restful, so peaceful, so warm, where folk come to get drunk on Whit Friday. She sang of a meadow by a river of sorts, where 26 men fought a battle in shorts. Without effort, she to a fair altitude soared. Then she dropped like a stone, and she whistled the score, screaming, "Saddle word, that's not enough." When she gave me the sad tones of Highmore, of the fly tipping sides, while her throat warbled sore, and 'twasn't only the ice or the burgled her breath, 'twas the sound of a slug as it heralded death. But larks still sing on Highmore.
John Willie's granddad went to France, and he roamed the Riviera in his underpants, singing "Tickle Me Fancy" and "Ooh La La." Gendarmes rushed from near and far, immobilized them till they'd had enough, singing "Never rub your head against a roughy edge yet, 'cause a roughy edge yet's right rough. Never rub your head against a roughy edge yet, 'cause a roughy edge yet's right rough." Ten bobbies up the cul-de-sac, gave blow for blow and crack for crack, shouting "Eau de Cologne" and "Negligé." Took 56 gendarmes to put him away from his prison cell. You could hear his voice far off. Never rub your head against a roughy edge yet, 'cause a roughy edge yet's right rough. Well, he bent the bars of his prison cell, and he damned them French gendarmes to hell. Then he shinned down the wall where a coup de grace, he slipped but he landed on his pally ass. Like the slopstone ghost, he bellowed up the soul. Never rub your head against a roughy edge yet, 'cause a roughy edge yet's right rough.
So if ever you visit the town of Nice and you want to fear the nice Nice police, mention John Willie's grandad and the Slopstone ghost. They'll jump and shout and leave their post. No longer will they stand there big and tall. They say never ruffian against a ruffian shed, cause a ruffian shed's right rough. John Willie's grandad plays for Wigan now, it's second row and bug me how, but they say he'll never do a tour of France. The bobbies would recognise his underpants and his tattling that is far from powder puff. Never ruffy head against a ruffy head shed, cause a ruffy head shed's right rough. Ooh. Never ruffy head against a ruffy head shed, cause a ruffy head shed's right rough.
His boots are cracking for want of liking, and his elbow stick old is wanting mending until they send him to the Dardanelles.
Charlie Chaplin, meek and mild, swiped a sausage from a child when the child began to cry. Charlie socked him in the eye,
and the moon shines bright on Charlie Chaplin. His boots are cracking for want of liking, and his elf will stick old his wanting mending until they send him to the Dardanelles.
Charlie Chaplin had no sense, he bought a fiddle for 18 pence, and the only tune that he could play was Tarara Bundie.
And the moon shines bright on Charlie Chaplin, his boots are cracking for want of liking, and his elf will stick old his wanting mending until they send him to the Dardanelles.
Charlie Chaplin went to France to teach the ladies how to dance. First you wheel and then you tow, lift up your skirts and round you go.
And the moon shines bright on Charlie Chaplin, his boots are cracking for want of liking, and his elf will stick old his wanting mending until they send him to the Dardanelles.
Charlie, Charlie, chuck, 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 went to bed with three white ducks. One died, Charlie cried,
Charlie, Charlie, chuck, chuck, chuck. And the moon shines bright on Charlie Chaplin, his boots are cracking for want of liking, and his house will stick out his wanting mending until they send him to the Dardanelles.
Sir, a standing at the door, a Lara
kissing Charlie Chaplin. And the moon shines bright on Charlie Chaplin, his boots are cracking for want of liking, and his elf will stick out his wanting mending until they send him to the Dardanelles.
How Paddy were an Irishman, Grove village were to cart. Sunshine on two legs, he were a pumpkin for a heart. Each day to him were Christmas, no one day were set apart. Dee-da-da-da-doo-da-dee. And now how Paddy's dead. Childer come from miles around to watch him cleaning streets. He allers had a till to tell him pockets full of sweets. His cab a fairy grotto in a land where nobody cheats. Dee da 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 doo da daddy, and now how Paddy's dead. He were by strange coincidence born on Christmas Day. Some say his good Lord planned that in his own mysterious way. But stranger still, last Yuletide gone, how Paddy passed away. Dee da 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 doo da daddy, fancy how Paddy dead. He'd mowed the lawn or trimmed the hedge, cut her his former tread, walk the dog or feed the rabbits, get the footpath led. No matter how folk pressed him, Paddy saw his knob depend. Dee da 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 doo da daddy, and now how Paddy's dead. The summers get state funerals, live presidents and such. A started wars and had folk shot and lacked the human touch. Does one see Paddy's monument, it's my lad's rabbit hutch. Dee da 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 dee daddy, fancy how Paddy den.
Dark land, so weird and stern, the old king held his throne. His pillows were twined by the lady fern, and reared on the granite stone. And the fossil shells around him lay, from the ancient ocean's roll. So dark and grim from the vast sea spray was born our old King Cole. Then here's to King Cole, that merry old soul, we'll give it with three times three. His eye is bright, may its merry light wink always sly at me. Now old King Cole has left his land, a conquering far and near. The steamship is his battle horse, the railway train his car. The bell which swings in the steeple high, the sword by the soldier's side, the needles which beauty's fingers ply, and the crown of the monarch's pride, were shaped by the aid of old King Cole. What a merry old soul is he! His eye is bright, may its merry light wink always sly at me. But most I love the old King Cole, for he is a friend to me. He sits between me and my wife when we sit down to tea. And he leers on us both with a roguish eye, and he laughs like a dear old soul, and embraces both right royally, this neighborly old King Cole. Then here's to King Cole, that merry old soul, we'll give it with three times three. His eye is bright, may its merry light
wink always sly at me.
The very last Friday that ever there were, a trap with a chap in drove up to our door. It were loaded with loaves till no more it could tank, and chap on the box were a brave steeplejack. We go down a pit and he goes up a spire, both hazardous jobs as a mon can desire. We are ever in danger until we get back, and so is the chap that they call Steeplejack. I think that accounts for his coming so soon, with a load of loaves warm and nice from Thun. He couldna abide that poor colliers should lack, so down with his loaves come this brave Steeplejack. And then was some joy when we seed what he had, for her childer were scriking a butter cake dad. And some of those loaves disappeared in a crack, while blessings were showered on our brave Steeplejack. And that were not all, for he browed picks and shoes, that if they're a job, we should have tools to use. So I thought to reward him this song I would make, and tell all I know of this brave Steeplejack.
A friend of mine, I'll call him Tom, the woodhouses were going one. One dark night along the cut side, when near the crime lake a leety spied. It moved about on top of the brew, just o'er the cut, and Tom well knew that nobody should be there at all. Yet leet kept moving to and fro. It were, he sees, with some alarm, in Thempen, near B. Jackson's farm. By gum, thought Tom, there's someone there, who's after stealing thens, I fear. I cannot get o'er the cut it dark to put a stop to the wicked work. And if I go right round with lone, time I get there, they'll have gone. But suddenly, leet it seemed to glide down the brew and stopped at the weather side. Then what it were, Tom seed quite clear, and almost fell in cut with fear. His ear rose stiffly on his head, while down his spine a shiver sped. Damp were his brow, well might it be, at what his startled een could see. Out fashioned, strange, with pallid beam, a lantern shone, and in its gleam Tom seed an arm, and that were all, until this lamp with ghostly glow. "What dost thou want? And you a name?" Tom said as boggart nearer came. It moved o'er the cut and shone its light, and cut white stones down by his feet. No sound at all came from this thing, then swiftly like a brid on the wing it sped to the lake, cowed deep and wide, crossed o'er, then vanished on the far side. When Tom gave one, his missus said, "Well, mum, the ear stands on the head, like sprouting grass in spring at year. Summat's feared thee, that's clear." So to his good wife, Tom towed his tale, a tharm and lamp with leets a pale, and said, "If things like yon I meet, I'll keep away from the crime at neat."
Lads will come next week, hooray, hooray. We think they've got a lot of cheek, hooray, hooray. We'll run them off their blessed feet, and our trial line they'll never see. And we'll shout hooray on Saturday night when we come marching home.
They think to do the on it's sick, hooray, hooray. But they are not one half so quick, hooray, hooray.
We'll see them sat on with elite and cheer all day and shout all night, but we'll not boo them, that's not right, when we come marching home.
Let us make a vow, dear friends, hooray,
hooray,
to do the right hour it ends,
hooray, hooray,
send harsh words on either side and by the referee abide, and then the match will be enjoyed as we come marching home.
The Rangers came down with a bearing all bold, and the followers were chinking their silver and gold, and the crowds that were there were a marvel to see when Selby kicked off at a 3:15. Now the Rangers have brought, and they're loud in their wail, and they tell all that come of a wonderful tale, how the might of the ruffians the record has lowered, and Oldham's position as Premier restored.
Play up the Murrays, we are the boys to win. Play up the Murrays, we never do give in. For every time we score a try, we score it neat and bright. We are the little champions dressed in black and white.
It's in a team in blue, lads, a sweet little team in blue. They were ranking and they were swanking about what they were going to do. Jim Valentine got the ball, lads, and thought he would easily score. But Valley copped him and gently dropped him. They'll meet on an happier shore.
We walk around the Huddersfield ground with an independent herd. You could hear them all declare they think they're million herd.
But for miles and miles and miles about the villages, they could hear the shouts of the lads who come to shout for Gallic Howdown.
You'll see, if you'll only look at me. The other night I met McCarthy, going on his way, he to me did say, won't you come down to our party? Our house to be sure will be crowded to the door. Everyone will be gay and hearty. Towers, Book and Baileys will be there with their shillelaghs.
Down at McCarthy's party, oh, at McCarthy's party, everyone was hearty till someone hit Maloney on the nose with the handle of a broom. Oh, Harris swept the room. Then a row arose, it was murder. Geary and his cousin paralysed a half a dozen. They hit both swift and hard, and a number of the boys will never make a noise because they're lying in the old churchyard.
What began the row? I'll tell it to you now. Burke, you see, was a bit of a dandy. Maloney, he got up, said he was a pup, told him straight that he wasn't worth candy. Murphy took a look, the frying pan he took. Poor Maloney's nose came handy, hit him such a clatter, right across the snatter.
Down at McCarthy's party, oh, at McCarthy's party, everyone was hearty till someone hit Maloney on the nose with the handle of the broom. Oh, Harris swept the room. Then a row arose, it was murder. Geary and his cousin paralysed a half a dozen. They hit both swift and hard, and a number of the boys will never make a noise because they're lying in the old churchyard.
A lady she did try, she tried to pacify Trot, but she was a fine old creature, singing like a bull, she was beautiful. Madam Hammond couldn't imitate her, she opened up her mouth, north, east, west and south, for all the world like an alligator. Couldn't get it shut, so Murphy put his foot,
we're down at McCarthy's party. Oh, at McCarthy's party, everyone was hard hit, till someone hit Maloney on the nose with the handle of a broom. Oh, Harris swept the room, then a row arose. It was murder, Geary and his cousin paralyzed a half a dozen. They hit both swift and hard, and a number of the boys will never make a noise, because they're lying in the out churchyard.
We come a cob calling for bonfire time, your coal and your money we hope you'll enjoy. Fa-la-day, fa-la-day, fa-la-diddle-i-do-day. Down in yon cellar there lives an out feller, we nout on his Cornish but an out pepper box. Pepper box, pepper box, morning till night. If you give us nout, we'll steal nout, God bless you, good night. Up a ladder, down a wall, a cob of coal will save us all. You haven't got a penny, eight and you'll do if you haven't got eight and God bless you. We knock at your knocker and ring at your bell to see what you'll give us for singing so well, singing so well. Reevesy's pony let a trump, knock poor Reevesy off his chump. Reevesy swore he'd punce his rump, hurrah for Reevesy's pony. Rosy apple, a lemon or a pear, gold and silver she must wear, a silver bridle by her side, for she's the one to be his bride. Take her by the lily white hand, take her by the water, give her a shove and knock her out, for she's the miller's daughter. The corporation muck cart was filled up to the brim. The corporation driver fell in and could not swim. He sank right to the bottom just like a little stone, and then he started singing, there's no place like home, there's no place like home. I'm a full loom weaver, as many one knows. I've no teeth and I've wore out me clothes. Clogs are both broken and stockings are numb. That hardly give me tuppence for all I've gotten on. Old Billy Bensy been telling me long, women are hard, better times if I never tell me tongue. Well, I've held me tongue till I near lost me breath, when I feel in me heart as I'll soon clem to death. I'm a full loom weaver, as many one knows. I've no teeth and I've wore out me clothes. Billy's all right, but he ne'er were clemmed, and he ne'er picked o'er in his life. We hung on for 6 weeks, thout each day were the last. We tarried and shipped it till now we're quite fast. We lived upon nettles whilst nettles were good, and Waterloo porridge
weren't best o's food. Our Margaret declares if who clothes to put on, who'd go up to London for to see the great man. And if things didn't alter when there who I've been, who reckons old fate we blood up to thin. I'm a fallen weaver, as many one knows. I've nerved teeth and I've wore out me clothes. Clongs I have none and no looms to weave on. And I've woven myself to far end.
Talk about your ragtime brass band, your cigar band, and your rap band. We've got a band that's all the sway. It's a band down our way. Well, talk about your ragtime trombone, and your wishbone, and your fishbone. When you've all done a playing, you can out your breath. We got all the other fellas skinned to death, 'cause I've skinned them all myself. Oh, oh, John Will is a ragtime band. Oh, oh, John Will is a ragtime band. Hear us when we play on Wigging Pier, and mill girls flock around and give a cheer, and the colliers all shout back on me ear. Itchy-coo, itchy-coo, itchy-coo. We dress just like the Horse Guards Blue. We've won gout cups and saucers too. In Bury now, they do it grand. They hop round with black puddings in the rondo in the ear. John Willis, ragtime band. Baby dear, listen here, zin. Oh, oh, John Willis, a ragtime band. When we play, all the people faint away. Oh, oh, John Willis, a ragtime band. What's a mob when we're out upon the job? Heroes, oh, when we play on Biggie Beer. And mill girls flock around and give a cheer. On the colliers all shout back on me ear. Itchy-coo, itchy-coo, mind the beer. We dress just like the Horse Guards Blue. A leather dogs and a pair of nobby's clubs. We've won gout cups and saucers too. No mistake, we're the lads to take the cake. In Bolton now, they know a lot. With a cow wheel in their hand, they can do the turkey trot to win the year. John Willis, ragtime band. Baby dear, listen here, zim.
Sons of labour, clear the way. Blats and coal, they all do say, is the shop for better pay, with a golden check on Friday.
Flag of labour now unfold, while to you a tale is told. It's not of Australia's gold, nor a place in California.
Sons of labour, clear the way. Blats and coal, they all do say, is a shop for better pay, with a golden check on Friday.
of a place in Oldham town, a workshop of great renown, known in every trade in town, almost Europe over.
Sons of labour clear the way, plats and coal they all do say, is a shop for better pay, with a golden check on Friday.
Morning we start at six, everyone with a pocket full of checks, and he pops one onto the box of tricks for his ready money on Friday.
Sons of labour clear the way, plats and coal they all do say, is a shop for better pay with a golden check on Friday.
To you who read as well as run, how little towns are to reach. And if you want to see some fun, come round on market night. For if you'll view our market square and stand about a while, you'll see some things to make you stir and some to make you smile. They'll sell you out, our market folk, they're cute as I can tell. And if you dunno watch these blokes, they'll soon get out they sell. They sell black leads as a winner right, or beer as a winner pop. There's apples too, you canna bite, with ripens all on top. This keckle stands as winner stand, gout rings that are no gout. The stilt and cheese with whiskers on, cock chickens 10 year out. The champagne too was novel sham, there's bacon, nook and creep. There's turnips labelled apple jam, and lamb that's turned to sheep. We have a doctor quack and all, he'll cure you in a flash. He'll ease you of your gouty cold, your colic and your cash. He'll diagnose your aches and pains, he'll make you feel your bad. And then he'll shift your muggle brains, and them's you never had. He'll put you right from top to toe, he'll cure your corns and warts. And then he'll shift your ouching yet, brought on through supping quarts. He shifted boils in barrelfuls, it's true but you can tell. He scored a testimonials, he's written out his cell. He stuffed for making whiskers grow where whiskers never grew. It says so on the paper, so of course it must be true. So come and visit Dr. Quack, he's such a great leg up. And if he cannot cure your back, it's grand to wear him tall.
Apples are pound pears, rabbits as big as bears, carrots with knobs on, turnips with clogs on. The only firm that sells 1 and 9 pence worth for 2 bob.
We have a fortune teller too, he's clever you can see. He'll tell you all you're bound to do, and who your wife'll be. He warns you to be careful as you take a walk in park. He says you'll meet a gypsy lass who's very tall and dark. He says that you'll have children too, he reckons you'll have three. But if he knows there's kids enough, he'll tell you when they'll be. He wears blue goggles or his zine, and he has a cap and gown. He calls himself Professor Green, the seer of world renown.
now he's one of the biggest liars that bugger's killed with ye. He carries bobbins up at Squires for 19 bob a week. So come and see our market square and stand about a while. You'll see some things to make you stir and some to make you smile.
A good time coming, boys, a good time coming, though we may not live to see the day the earth shall glisten in the rain. A good time coming. Cannonballs may hit the truth, but thoughts are weapons stronger. We'll win the battle with its aid.
Wait a little longer, there's a good time coming, boys, a good time coming, there's a good time coming, boys. Wait a little longer,
there's a good time coming, boys, a good time coming. Little children shall not toil above or underneath the soil in the good time coming, but shall play in healthful fields while limbs and mind grow stronger, and everyone will read and write.
Wait a little longer, there's a good time coming, boys, a good time coming, there's a good time coming, boys. Wait a little longer,
there's a good time coming, boys, a good time coming. War in all men's eyes shall be a monster of iniquity in the good time coming. Nations shall not quarrel then to prove which is the stronger, nor slaughter men for glory's sake.
Wait a little longer, there's a good time coming, boys, a good time coming, there's a good time coming, boys. Wait a little longer.
Kit of Windham Manor and Jack of Oldham Mill, how long they could, a faithful Jack and Jill. But times were bad for the lass and lad, and sadly both confessed 'twas not the thing to buy the ring before they'd lined their nest. Courage, lad, said Katie, yes, we'll have to wait. But though, my dear, it's 20 year, I'll take no other mate. Courage, lad, said Katie, yes, we'll have to wait. But though, my dear, it's 20 year, I'll take no other mate. England wanted Jack now, for war was in the air, and arms more grim were pressed on him than Katie's bonny pair. So off to Spain in a rough campaign, he chivied bold myself, and he fired his gun and he made him run like fun at Waterloo. Lads round Katie gathered, but Katie bade them pack. There's girls enough for you to woo, I means to wait for Jack. The lads round Katie gathered, but Katie bade them pack. There's girls enough for you to woo. I means to wait for Jack. A grey in Katie's ringlets was mingling with the brown. When bump a thump, an eager stump came pegging through the town. It's me, you see, come one, says he, except a leg or so. And safe and sound, here's £20, so let the parson know. Jingle, 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 set the bells a-chime. To health, to bliss, to love like this, that bravely bides its time. Jingle, 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 set the bells a-chime. To health, to bliss, to love like this, that bravely bides.
You can keep your slopes at Aviemore and your Alps of Eastern France, to your winter sports in Austria, we wouldn't go given a chance. Where do the Oldham topknobs go to gain their winter thrill? Oh, they don their togs and they point their clogs to the ski slope on Count Hill. Oh, this Oldham sporting focal point fills us with civic pride. There's folk comes up from Hollywood and Mumps and Shaw beside. To the Highfield après ski lodge, they come from near and far. On this sub mile bay, we pull Newty nice from the glacier at Grains Bar. Oh, you've seen them ski à la française, with lumps of wood on feet. If you've nursing skiing out in style, you've missed a gradely treat. They slalom down the man-made slopes, a-dodging dandelions, sitting on lumps of cardboard and corrugated irons. Oh, they've written to see if the Olympic Games can be held on our slopes. As yet they've gotten no reply, but council lives in hopes. They've got five iron ringer wheels to put up on full view, and for the Olympic Village there'll be flats near Bardsley Brew. So if you come to Oldham Town, there's things you must remember. Were your britches backside torn from April to September? Torn pants are a state's a symbol now, so bear up with a will. And you look like one of the trendy set that skis up on Count Hill.
In a cosy cottage green, and on a Sunday morning when it's fine, I often goes and sits with him to have a smoke and chat, because he is a dear friend of mine. And when it's getting dinner time and dinner's ready, then I think it must be time for me to go. But he goes and hangs me at up just behind the out front door, and then to my surprise I hear him say, "He, I'm always glad to see a man like me. That's as welcome, lad, as welcome as can be. Fudge the cheer up to tables
up as long as at our table, for I'm always glad to see a man like me. One day when I was sat with him, there came a loud rat-tat. There came a loud rat-tat on the axe front door. He hurries over to open it, and there to his surprise, an hungry, tattered beggar stood outside. He asked Jack for a crust of bread. Jack looked him through and through, and then said, bless the heart, lad, come inside. And he went and hung his hat up just behind the out front door. And to the tramp's surprise, he heard Jack say, he am always glad to see him all like thee. That's as welcome, lad, as welcome as can be. Fudge the cheer up to table, stop as long as thou art able, for I'm always glad to see a man like thee. Now that beggar did not eat a bit, but down his pale face streaming, the tears came flowing like a shower of rain. He cried, Jack, dost thou know me? Dost thou know me, long lost brother? These 50 years away, now back again. I've only put these clothes on, just me lad, to try me, for I'm not poor but rich as I need you. And that welcome to it all, lad, the wife and children too. And that's because me lad, I've found thee true. Hey, I'm always glad to see a man like thee. That's as welcome, lad, as welcome as can be. Fudge the cheer up to table, stop as long as thou art able, for I'm always glad to see a man like thee.
It happened till the Monday morn, while seated at me loonses, pulling thems from out at yarn, our nan pops into room, says, who shouted out, I tell the dick, I think that acting shabby. So off to London, cut the stick and look at Royal Babby.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all at Oldham, and asked if folk were all like me as I'm to come from Oldham.
So off I goes and never stops until in Palace Handy. Chow was sucking lollipops, plums and sugar candy. And little Vic in nook I spied with a monkey on her lap, mon. And Albert sitting by her side, mixing gin and pop, mon.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all at Oldham, and asked if folk were all like me as happened to come from Oldham.
When Albert seen me, up he jumps, and straight to me did waddle, and little Vicky sprung her pumps, was shaking o' me daddle. They asked me to have a glass of wine, for pleasure up it waxes. Oh yes, says I, sir, 8 to 9, it all comes out at taxes.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all at Oldham, and asked if folk were all like me, as had to come from Oldham.
They said they'd send their son to school as soon as he could walk, mon. And then for fear he'd be a fool, they'd learn him thold and talk, mon. I said there's summat else as well, there's nowt like draining thold pit. For fear he'll have to keep his cell, I'd learn it work down coal pit.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all at Oldham, and asked if folk were all like me as happened to come from Oldham.
Then up at Slopes we had a walk to give our joints releases, and then we sat us down to talk about politics and beefs. I said bad times would have to mend and taxes would have to drop, mum. So when our nan were making broth, some fat might get to top, mum.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all I told them, and asked if folk were all like me as happened to come from Oldham.
So now you see I've told me sprees and out, but truth I tell says, and if you want bad times to mend, you laugh at do-it-yourself says. So now you see I've told me tale, and just as I am with mum, if my old wife and Albert die, I try and wed with it mum.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all I told them, and I stiff folk were all like me as happened to come from Oldham.
We marched to our places with clean hands and faces, and pay great attention to all we are told. For we know we can never be happy or clever, for learning is better than silver and gold. We march to our places with clean hands and faces, and pay great attention to all we are told.
In our town, to school I go, teacher lets us call him Joe. Everything he seems to know, but he never tells us at doing maths I'm very good. Bits of paper on lumps of wood. What's three times three? Well, I'd tell you if I could, but we've not been taught it. Our language lab, well, it's best in land, but we've no electric man on hand. So it's used by the school brass band. Headmaster plays a trumpet. I'm top in art, I don't have to slog. Miss likes me portrait of a moorland bog. It were done by our dog. I found a new medium. We've health inspections three times a week. Into our eyes, nose and ears they peek. With three fifth formers got destroyed last week. What a loss to the nation. In our town, to school I go, teacher lets us call him Joe. Everything he seems to know, he never tells
us. Mister is hermano, no se dolcharva. I dolce arvan, musidino son vorena amata.
Amadim, 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 rundum. Tiridini, 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 rundum. Vermano son don pare di rundum.
T'was on the plains of Oldham's burning sands that I was born with fingers on both hands. And down below the orange groves of Wormuth, I was made the premier dancer of them all.
in the earlham, where they were and pretty low, and sometimes where they were and none at all. When the Sultan saw me do me cowheel glide, well, I blushed and dropped me eyes onto the floor.
In me quaint Egyptian style, me quaint Egyptian style, I will wriggle, twist and twiggle like a crocodile. Hear me Egyptian language flow.
He nim me nim my nim mo. Penny on the water, out go she. It's your coup, it's a treat. Skinny Lizzie is the Urim Queen.
Mister Intende, stra modo gende. Tutta montende istra vaino zonde. Las drivide sena mono se se mono se. Nar montande istra mado jode.
Well, the Urim clock had just struck 10 to 4 when the Sultan met me at the Urim door. He sent me sugar plum. That's captivating me, and I blushed and I dropped my eyes onto the floor. In the Urim, where they were a pretty low, and sometimes where they were and none at all. When the Sultan saw me do me cowheel glide, well, I blushed and dropped my eyes onto the floor.
In me quaint Egyptian style, me quaint Egyptian style, I will wriggle, twist and twiggle like a crocodile. Hear me Egyptian language flow.
He need me, need my, need more. Penny on the water, out goes she. Itchy coo, it's a treat. Skinny Lizzie is the Urim Queen.
With me mum and me dad, we ne'er had any fun. So I taken it into me head one day away from one mad run. And then I met two silly fat buggers, me crimes, they made me mad. For they were grinning all over the face at me, an Oldham lad. Like a fine old English gentleman, one of the old brigade. Well, I went to church next morning, I'd never been there in me days. Me crimes, I were ashamed of myself, I didn't know their ways. There were young folk, there were old folk, in tubs and boxy sat. And a silly old bugger sat next to me, said, lad, take off the hat. Like a fine old English gentleman, one of the old brigade. Well, then enters big Lord Mur, or he shouted, he'd a club. He first shoves into a long white shirt and then into topmost tub. He's preaching about good folk going to heaven and bad folk going to hell. I said, sit thee down, that silly old bugger that's never been there to sell. Like a fine old English gentleman, one of the old brigade. Well, the fella comes in with a plate of brass, he crimes, he hands it round. And me not being a skinny old bugger, I goes and takes half a crown. And a silly old bugger sat next to me, I thought he were bound to die. I said, sit thee down, that silly old bugger, I've left some in for thee. Like a fine old English gentleman, one of the old brigade. When preaching and praying were our, and we all are going away, I goes up to fella with long white shirt to save us out to pay. He said, no, me land, I'd not to pay, the crimes I were nothing. So I picks up me hat and me coat and me cane, and I buggers up one again. Like a fine old English gentleman, one of the outbreaking.
On Peter's Field in Manchester in year 1819, when
Lancashire in protest did combine. Corn laws had brought their crippling tax, a price of food near broke folks' backs, and set a leet at smouldering flax, and it bristled many a spine. Salute once more these men of yore who were to conscience true, and give their blood for common good on field of Peterloo. 16th day of August sprouts the sound of marching feet, when workers 50,000 strong on Peter's Field did meet. In Mount Street from an upstairs room, the magistrates looked down with gloom, and scoffed this rabble, all the loon, vengeance they thought is sweet. Salute once more these men of yore who were to conscience true, and give their blood for common good on field of Peterloo. Then riot acts were gobbled out at Parsonage command. For this here Rochdale vicar made with richest living in the land. But folk at meeting never knew or thry attacked till bugles blew. A mounted red coats come in view with sabres in their run. Salute once more these men of yore who were to conscience too, and give their blood for common good on field of Peterloo. These soldiers mowed folk down like flies, their sabres dripped with blood. They gombed no manner woman's cries, but pierced them where they stood. Money deed that day were named, and hundreds more were hurt and lamed. While tyrants watching unashamed said it to do them good. Salute once more these men of yore who were to conscience true, and give their blood for common good on field of Peterloo. For many a year folk struggled on till 1832, before might come corn laws were gone and food were cheaper too. John Bright and Compton paved the way, and now where Peter's Fields once lay. Well, free trade all it stands today on field of Peterloo. Salute once more these men of yore who were to conscience true, and give their blood for common.
I was a woman, I lived with me granny, and many a bashing me granny gave me. She dressed me up in the quality fashion and tied a garter below me knee. Have you seen my love, my love, my love? Have you seen my love waiting for me? He wears a green coat, a pair of red stockings, and up on his back, and he's only one knee. Oh, the doss house where we used to stay turned an old fella's whiskers grey. We hadn't any light or any
heat.
The house was doubly rented, and the bedclothes, they were scented. by the perfume of the lodger's sweaty feet.
What a smell.
The bacon, it was wooden, we were fed on cast iron pudding, and the fragments of the dripping stopped the clock.
Stop the clock.
The cake was just like lead, there were whiskers around the bread, and the tea was brewed in 1849.
Holy Moses, I am dying, dying for the want of bread. Stretch the cat out on the table, stick some pepper on it. Holy Moses, I am dying, dying for the want of bread. Stretch the cat out on the table, stick some pepper on its head. Who's that knocking at the window? Who's that knocking at the door? Oh, it's little Mary Ann with a candle in her hand, and she's going down the cellar for some coal. Tramp, 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 the boys are marching, cheer up, the bobbies at the door. And if you don't let us in, we'll break all your windows in, and you'll never see your daddy anymore.
That night I met my Elsie Bell by Daddy Longlegs' bed. My heart still cherished from the night before the word she'd said. She'd said she loved me dearly, and to me would cling for aye, like the crimson clouds to Winter Hill, as the sun dipped in the sky. She 19 years, I 21, had trod for just 1 year. The hills were oft the curlew's cry, fall shrill upon the ear. And many a tale I'd told my love, as we strode through Tandle Hills, and we'd often gazed at galaxies of light-locked cotton mills. This night as I approached my love with eager outstretched hand, her eyes shone glazed and fathomless like any lake becalmed. I asked her if she loved me, she ne'er answered aye nor nay, but raised her pretty head aloft, and unto me did say, my love for you was but a whim of childhood fancy free. I'm much matured since yesterday, and now more clearly see. My parents tell me that you are not fit to share my bed, so to a finer, richer man in autumn I'll be wed. In shock, the slopes of Oldham Edge I started to descend. my eyes brimful of salty tears. My way to town I did wend. What could I do to cure the grief, the pain in my heart to ease? I went into a chip shop in Barker Street, and I'd put in chips and peas. Oh, noble man, you'll see, if you'll only look at me. The other night I met McCarthy, going on his way, he to me did say, won't you come down to our party? Our house to be sure will be crowded to the door. Everyone will be gay and hearty. Towers, Book and Baileys will be there with their shillelaghs. Down at McCarthy's party, oh, at McCarthy's party, everyone was hearty till someone hit Maloney on the nose with the handle of a broom. Oh, Harris swept the room. Then a row arose, it was murder. Geary and his cousin paralysed a half a dozen. They hit both swift and hard, and a number of the boys will never make a noise because they're lying in the old churchyard. What began the row? I'll tell it to you now. Burke, you see, was a bit of a dandy. Maloney, he got up, said he was a pup, told him straight that he wasn't worth candy. Murphy took a look, the frying pan he took. Poor Maloney's nose came handy, hit him such a clatter, right across the snatter. Down at McCarthy's party, oh, at McCarthy's party, everyone was hearty till someone hit Maloney on the nose with the handle of a broom. Oh, Harris swept the room. Then a row arose, it was murder. Geary and his cousin paralysed a half a dozen. They hit both swift and hard, and a number of the boys will never make a noise because they're lying in the old churchyard.
A lady, she did try, she tried to pacify Trot, but she was a fine old creature, singing like a bull, she was beautiful. Madam Hammond couldn't imitate her, she opened up her mouth, north, east, west and south, for all the world like an alligator. Couldn't get it shut, so Murphy put his foot.
We're down at McCarthy's party, oh, at McCarthy's party, everyone was hearty till someone hit Maloney on the nose with the handle of a broom. Oh, Harris swept the room. Then a row arose, it was murder. Geary and his cousin paralysed a half a dozen. They hit both swift and hard, and a number of the boys will never make a noise because they're lying in the old churchyard.
Winker drove a cart for a brewer down at Shea. With full ale barrels he'd start on a journey every day. Empty kegs he'd get from some, but a shameful tale to tell. When with empties he get one, he were off brimful his cell. Oh, Billy, what a mon,
Life's last bottle soon thou spent. Now thou's sucked all till thou come. It were getting time thou went. Customers na thinking wrong. Used to give him allowance glasses, milder, bitter, weak and strong. Every make from coops to basses. Winker all a subtle lot. Out where eat is spark to sleck. Jug a bottle, glass a pot. He could empty down his neck. Oh, Billy, what a mon. Life's last bottle soon thou spent. Now thou's supped all till thou gone. It were getting time thou went. Bill grew fat and Bill grew fatter. All his nose with shame went pink. He'd forgotten taste of water. Sin he'd turned to mix his drink. So it is bad habits floor. Best at folk at live be sweat. If he'd stuck to milk it sure. Fella could have been here yet. Oh, Billy, what a mon. Life's last bottle soon thou spent. Now thou's supped all till thou come. It were getting time thou went. Billy's master soft in yet. Called his mon in one fine day. Here's 9 gallon lad, he said. Tack it one, there's nought to pay. Thou can swallow well, I think, or thou'll be lied be folk. Set this elt aside, this drink, and I'll time it just for joke. Oh, Billy, what a month. Life's last bottle soon thou spent. Now thou's supped all till thou come. It were getting time thou went. Billy thanked him with a grin. Barrel on his shoulder cocked. Made for woman safely in. Front and back his doors he locked. Tapped his bunk and down he sit. Buckling to a night's hard work. Tales so fast began to flit. It were well he gone be dark. Oh, Billy, what a mon. Life's last bottle soon thou spent. Now thou's sucked all till thou come. It were getting time thou went. Morning come be 9 o'clock. Back with barrel Billy went. Standing steady as a rock, filling spot with balmy scent. Done be now his master cries, Billy Winker that a cure. Done why man to tell no lies, for supper had to forge some more. Oh, Billy, what a man, life's last bottle soon thou spent. Now thou's supped all till thou come. It were getting time thou went. Put the barrel down in nook. Brewer said, thou settle me. Bill ne shat to take his oak, but stood his ground with twinkling e. What art standing there for bout? Brewer shouted in a crack. Come, says Billy, is the nout at all for bringing barrel back? Oh, Billy, what a mon. Life's last bottle soon thou spent. Now thou's supped all till thou come. It were getting time thou went.
Thank you. From between the shafts of a ragman's cart, John Willie took an horse. He fed him duck and muffins and it rained him for the course. He raced him at every race course against the finest and the choice. But there wasn't a mount in England as could lick John Willie's horse.
Lick John Willie's horse.
Well, a favourite with the gentry at Ascot Royal one day, unaffected by the royalty and wealth and finery, he quickly took the lead and was the first to end the course. To the cheers of the lords and ladies shouting, up John Willie's horse.
Up John Willie's horse.
Once Jimmy Frizzle sent for him when fluent in his toe. He turned out for the Latics and he scored the winning goal. The crowd went mad and cheered and sang and shouted themselves hoarse. And the players, they all gathered round to kiss John Willie's horse.
Kiss John Willie's horse.
Last year the Oldham Show was held in the Miglet town. There were mirrors in mirrors on parlour, there was horse flesh shown all round. There were donkeys shown on greaves, arm steps and stallions too, of course. But between the pillars on the town hall steps, John Willie showed his horse.
John Willie showed his horse.
Yee-haw!
It happened to the Monday morn while seated at me loomses, pulling pens from out at yarn, our nan pops into roomses, who shouted out, I tell the Dick, I think that acting shabby. So off to London, cut the stick and look at Royal Babby.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all at Oldham, and axed if folk were all like me as I'm to come from Oldham.
So off I goes and never stops until in Palace Handy. Chow was sucking lollipops, plums and sugar candy. And little Vic in nook I spied with a monkey on her lap, mon. And Albert sitting by her side, mixing gin and pop, mon.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all at Oldham, and asked if folk were all like me as happened to come from Oldham.
When Albert seen me, up he jumps and straight to me did waddle, and little Vicky sprung her pumps, was shaking all me daddle. They asked me to have a glass of wine for pleasure, up it waxes. Oh yes, says I, sir, 8 to 9, it all comes out at taxes.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all at Oldham, and asked if folk were all like me as happened to come from Oldham.
They said they'd send their son to school as soon as he could walk, mon. And then for fear he'd be a fool, they'd learn him Tholdham talk, mon. I said there's summat else as well, there's nowt like draining thorp it. For fear he'll have to keep his cell, I'd learn it work down Coalpit.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all at Oldham, and asked if folk were all like me as happened to come from Oldham.
Then up at Slopes we had a walk to give our joints releases, and then we sat us down to talk about politics and beefses. I said bad times would have to mend and taxes would have to drop, mum. So when our nan were making broth, some fat might get to top, mum.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all I told them, and asked if folk were all like me as happened to come from Oldham.
So now you see I've town my sprees and out, but truth I tell says, and if you want bad times to mend, you laugh at do it yourself says. So now you see I've town my tale, and just as I am with mum, if my old wife and Albert die, I'll try and wed with it mum.
Everything were fun and glee, they laughed at all I told them, and I stiff folk were all like me as happened to come from Oldham.
Attempt to describe the charms of my favourite fur. She's the darling of Mother Eve's tribe, and with her there is none to compare. She's a pride, a beauty so bright, her image may fancy enriches. Oh, me charmer's the village delight, she's the pride of the Lancashire witches. And hurrah for the Lancashire witches, whose smile every bosom enriches. Oh, dearly I prize those pretty blue eyes of the pride of the Lancashire witches. We can talk o' your dark eyes a spin, but it's useless to talk as you do. To try to compare them in vain with the Lancashire ladies in blue. Only view the dear heavenly bells, and you're soon filled with love's sudden twitches that only could come from the spells from the eyes of the Lancashire witches.
And hurrah for the Lancashire witches, who smile every bosom enriches. Oh, dearly I prize those pretty blue eyes of the pride of the Lancashire witches.
Oh, the Lancashire witches, believe me, are beautiful every one. And mine, or me fancy deceives me, she's prettiest under the sun. If the wealth of the Indies, I swear, were mine, and a wallet in riches, how dearly me fortune I'd share with the pride of the Lancashire witches.
And hurrah for the Lancashire witches, whose smile every bosom enriches. Oh, dearly I prize those pretty blue eyes of the pride of the Lancashire witches.
Well, I've just mended fire wi' a cob out swaddlers brought the new shoe. There's some nice bacon collops on thob and a quart of ale posset in thoon. I've brought the top coat dust I know, for the rain's coming down very dree, and third stone's as white as new snow. Come, womp, to the children me. And their sons as white as new snow come warm to the children me. When I put little Sally to bed, who cried cause her feather weren't there, so I kissed little thing and I said as who'd bring her a ribbon from fur. Then I give her a doll and some rags and a nice little white cotton bow, and I kissed her again but too sad, as who wanted to kiss thee and all. And I kissed her again, but too sad, as who wanted to kiss thee and know. And Dick too had such work wi' him, afore I could get him upstairs. Well, they promised they'd buy him a drum, he said when he was saying his prayers. Then he looked in me face and he said, as boggarts ta'en out o' me dad. And he cried till his een were quite red. He likes thee some well, does yon lad. And he cried till his een were quite red. He likes thee some well, does yon lad. Well, at long length I get him laid still, and I hearken folks' feet as went by, and I ironed me clothes right well, and I hung a month maiden to dry. Then I mended their stockings and shirts, and I sat down to knitting me cheer, and I really did feel rather hurt. Mon, I'm lonely when thou aren't there. And I really did feel rather hurt. Mon, I'm lonely when thou aren't there. I've a drum and a trumpet for Dick, I've a yard of blue ribbon for Sal, I've a book full of babs and a stick, and some bacca and pipes for myself. I've brought this home coffee and tea. If that feels in me pocket, there's see. And about though a new cap today, lass, I always bring summat for thee. And about though a new cap today, lass, I always bring summat for thee. God bless the mill, lass, I'll come warm, and I'll kiss thee and childer all round. For no matter wherever I roam, I'se fain to get back to thou ground. I can do wi' a crack o' a glass, I can do wi' a bit of a spree, but I've no greatly comfort, me lass, except wi' yon childer and thee. but I've no greatly comfort, me lass, except we are children and thee.
Each time our Joe became a dad, he'd act all posh and regal, and hoping it would be a lad, he'd book top room at Theagle. But every time he get let down, as lass would follow lass, his brow would wrinkle in a frown, and he'd scarcely raise his glass. Relations didn't mind one bit, 12 lovely do's they'd had. They'd say, well done, Joe, this is it, 10 bob says it's a lad. And when our Joe were 48, a lad, our Joe went daft. Top room at Theagle grown with weight, they supped, they scriked, they laughed. Who does he favour, Joe? Asked one, your Jem, your Jack, or Grace. Joe grinned, I've no idea, how'd son, I've ne'er looked at his face.
How Johnny Bugger, well, he lived be himself, as long as he had perfect health. He took unto himself a wife to look after him for the rest of his life, singing, I do believe, I will believe. How Johnny Bugger were a gay old bugger, and a gay old bugger were he. How Mrs. Bugger, she had a bad leg, and doctor ordered her to bed. He called Johnny in and he said to him, dost have to rub the wife's left leg with gin, singing, I do believe, I will believe. How Johnny Bugger were a gay old bugger, and a gay old bugger were he. How Johnny Bugger, now he thought it were a sin for to rub his wife's left leg with gin, so he geeting out at gin, he poured it down his throttle, rubbed his wife's left leg with boggle, singing, I do believe, I will believe. How Johnny Bugger were a gay old bugger, and a gay old bugger were he. How Johnny Bugger went a walking one day down Bit River, well, he chanced to stray. Johnny fell in and he started for to shout, there were no bugger there for to pull the bugger out, singing, I do believe, I will believe. How Johnny Bugger were a gay old bugger, and a gay old bugger were he. God made the bees and the bees made honey. God made man and a man made money. Man made the devil and the devil made sin. We staff to dig an hole for to put the bugger in, singing, I do believe, I will believe. How Johnny Bugger were a gay old bugger, and a gay old bugger were he.
Skip the maypole, we'll skip the maypole, tra-la-la-la-la.
Who made the flowers grow, the flowers grow, the flowers grow? Who made the flowers grow, tra-la-la-la-la?
God made the flowers grow, the flowers grow, the flowers grow. God made the flowers grow, tra-la-la-la-la.
And we'll skip the maypole, the maypole, the maypole. We'll skip the maypole, tra-la-la-la-la.
And who made the fishes swim, the fishes swim, the fishes swim? Who made the fishes swim, tra-la-la-la-la?
God made the fishes swim, the fishes swim, the fishes swim. God made the fishes swim, tra-la-la-la-la. And we'll skip the maypole, the maypole, the maypole. We'll skip the maypole, tra-la-la-la-la.
And who made the birdie sing, the birdie sing, the birdie sing? Who made the birdie sing, tra-la-la-la-la?
God made the birdie sing, the birdie sing, the birdie sing. God made the birdie sing, tra-la-la-la-la. And we'll skip the maypole, the maypole, the maypole. We'll skip the maypole, tra-la-la-la-la.
Out Dowser, he's a good old sort. He's eaten plenty brass. When fortune offered him a run, he didn't let it pass. But if a friend less favoured ever chanced to pass his way, he'd always grip him by his hand and unto him he'd say, "Come in, let's rest this ever out I'm sick. Us dollars make thee welcome, lad, for out I'm sick. So draw up that dear cheer, I'm right glad to see thee here. Come, lad, get thee down and have a chat, for out I'm sick." One winter's night, just after dark, the wind was howling wild. Out Towser found to hear the wailing of a little child. He opened up a door, and they're lying at his feet. A little babby on the step, exposed to bitter need. Come in, out and rest is ever out I'm sick. The stallers make me welcome, lad, for out I'm sick. So draw up that day cheer, I'm right glad to see thee. Come, lad, get thee down and have a chat, for out I'm sick. The years rolled on, the lass grew up, the joy of his out days. He says it's like God's angels spreading sunshine all through place. And as he works in garden, and so how we jogs along, he often hears his little Molly sing this dear out song. Come in, house and rest this ever out I'm sick. The stallers make me welcome, lad, for out I'm sick. So draw up that dear cheer, I'll make glad to see thee here. Come, lad, get me down and have a chat, for out I'm sick.
I'm in love with the furriest Signora, for she's such a dear little soul. She thinks that I'm an Italian too,
that's why she loves me top more. Her father, he liketh me not, of him I am daily in fear. So I wait till midnight until he's in bed, then I warble this song to me dear. Signora, signora, are you coming home tonight? Signora, signora, I'm here in the pale moonlight. If your father's spaghetti won't give his consent and says that you'll not marry me, I'll start a vendetta and stick my stiletto in a nice little place he will never forget. To signora, my love, I am waiting anxiously. So slip on your camisola, jump in my gondola, and book a goulide with me. Well, the first time I met Miss Signora, she was so busy making ice cream. I said, don't mind, she threw her glass eye, and that started love's young dream. On the freezer, we sat making love. She were just warming up to me when the freezer collapsed and she fell on her ice. And back home she were cool to me then. Now the father of my sweet Signora has a monkey that's called Ichiko, Ichiko. I'll never forget the first time as we met, and I think he'll remember it too. She said, let me introduce Dad. Then her father got up for a jar. I made a mistake and shook hands with the monkey, and then threw some nuts at her pa. Signora, signora, are you coming home tonight? Signora, signora, I'm here in the pale moonlight. If your father's spaghetti won't give his consent and says that you'll not marry me, I'll start a vendetta and stick my stiletto in a nice little place he will never forget. To signora, my love, I am waiting anxiously. So slip on your camisola, jump in my gondola, and book the doodle-i-do with me, sig me.
Michael in the row. Now Michael is the one who will have a bit of fun, but he won't play with Mavis anymore. That's a lie. All in, a bottle of gin. All out, a bottle of stout. All over, a bottle of clover. All through, a bottle of glue. As I was in the kitchen doing a bit of stitching, in came a bogeyman and knocked me out.
Our Larry is a funny un, he's a face like a skelly onion, he's a nose like a squash tomato, and legs like close props.
Laugh at him, look at him, throw a bit of muck at him, look at him, laugh at him, throw a bit of fat at him.
Tell, till, titch, your mother can't stitch, your father can't walk with a walking stick.
You're daft, you're potty, you made a treacle toffee. I like treacle toffee, but I don't like you.
On the mountain lives a lady, who she is I do not know. All she wants is gold and silver, all she wants is a nice young man. Call on your very best friend, your very best friend, your very best friend. Call on your very best friend and tell me who it will be.
Oily Boily Bob, he bought a tuppenny cob, a bit for thee and a bit for me and a bit for Oily Bob. If your Bob don't give our Bob that Bob that your Bob was our Bob will give your Bob a Bob on the nose.
Paddy on the railway picking up stones, along come an engine and broke his bones. Oh, says Paddy, that's not fair. Oh, said the engine, you shouldn't have been there. Along came another while Paddy was there. It pinched his trousers and barted his hair. It made the people laugh and stir to see poor Paddy with his bum bum burr.
Chin Chin Chinaman has a little shop. He sells Eccles cakes, ginger beer and pop. Chin Chin Chinaman has a little shop. Chin Chin Chinaman chop chop chop.
Left, right, a pen at the tripe. I lost me mother on Saturday night, and where do you think I found her? In the lobby, kissing a bobby and all the kids around her.
Where do you live?
Down a grid.
What number?
Cucumber.
What street?
Sweaty feet.
If you tread on a nick, you'll marry a stick and a blackjack will come to your wedding.
While shepherds wash their socks by night, all seated on the ground, the angel of the Lord came round and paid for pints all round. Good King Wenceslas last looked out from his bedroom window. He fell out and burnt his snout on a red hot cinder. Brightly shone his nose that night, though the frost was cruel. When Miss Sicky came in sight, riding on a mule.
A child lay on his mother's knee, she dandled it with joy and pride. I wonder what my child will be when I no more am by his side. Perhaps a warrior he'll become, and armies lead him proud array, to hear the martial fife and drum and proclaim that he has won the fray. Perhaps to statesmanship he will rise and grasp the rudder of the state, and leave a name that never dies among the noble and the great. Or if he may not speak the voice which promulgates a country's laws, perhaps in song he will rejoice a people's heart and plead the cause. Ah, thus she mused, thus on her knee, the smiling babe she fondly nursed. Nor thought that o'er his destiny, there hung the plight of the accursed. The mother died, the son lives on, but does her bosom proudly swell? To hear of victories he has won, oh no, he's in the feeling cell. No statesman's laurel crown for him, no poet's bays around his brow. Beside him stands a shadow grim, prepared to beckon, come, come now. And when that awful sign is made, he has no power to defy. As on his mother's knee he laid, she never dreamt the death he'd die.
Tommy Broadbent is no good, chop him up for firewood. When he's dead, stand him on his head, then we'll have some currant bread.
Dip for gold and dip for silver, dip for the one that you love best.
Down in the valley where the green grass grows, there, little Mary, she washes all her clothes. She sings, she sings, she sings so sweet. She sees her sweetheart walking down the street. Michael Patterson, he says as he loves her, all the boys are fighting for her. Let the boys do what they will, but Michael Patterson, he loves her still. He knocks at the door and he picks up the pin, saying, hey, Mrs. Cook, is your daughter in? She's neither in, she's neither out. She's in the back parlour, a-walking about. Sweetheart, sweetheart, will you marry me? Yes, sir, yes, sir. At half past three will be too late. We can't have the party till half past eight.
Dip for gold and dip for silver, dip for the one that you love best. I can remember how glad I used to be when Dad, her mother, would buy new shoes for me. That's the feeling we've all had, how new shoes would make you glad. But the best times, if you recall, was when we had no shoes at all. In barefoot days, when we were just a couple of kids, in barefoot days, oh boy, the things we did. We'd go down to Daisy Nook with a bent in for a nook, and we'd fish all day, we'd fish all night, but the bloody old fish refused to bite. And then off we'd go down some old cellar door. We'd slide and slide till our pants got tore a little more. And then we'd have to go home and lie in bed till our mother got busy with a needle and thread. Oh boy, what joy we had in barefoot days. Zim.
I went to the pictures tomorrow. I got a good seat at the back. A woman, she gave me some chocolate. I ate it and gave it her back.
One fine day, in the middle of the night, two dead men got up to fight. One blind man to see fair play, two dumb men to shout array. Back to back they faced each other, drew their swords and shot each other.
Nebuchadnezzar, the king of the Jews, he bought his wife a pair of shoes. When the shoes began to whir, Nebuchadnezzar began to swear. When the swearing began to stop, Nebuchadnezzar, he bought a shop. When the shop began to sell, Nebuchadnezzar, he bought a bell. When the bell began to ring, Nebuchadnezzar began to sing. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, how dare you tread on my big toe? Come in this church and sit you down. Put in this box and half a crown for Mrs. Wrigley and her gown.
Last Whit Friday on Saturday, a travelling circus came to town. Come and see, come and saw, two live elephants stuffed with straw. Admission free, pay at the door. Bring your own seats and sit on the floor.
Pancake Tuesday's a very fine day. If you don't give us holiday, we'll all run away. Where shall we run to? Down Sandy Lane, and we'll meet out scratch with a big fat cane.
I have no pains, oh mother dear, but oh, I am so dry. Connect me to the brewery and leave me there to die.
A pig and a chicken crossed the road just to stretch their legs. Along came a motor car. I'm an ex.
Lulu had a teddy and she called it Sunny Jim. She put it in the bathtub to teach it how to swim. It swallowed all the water and it ate all the soap. And it died last night with a bubble in its throat.
You know me Auntie Nelly, she had a big fat belly. And every time she touched it, out popped jelly.
Half a pound of ham to fry in the pan. No one to eat it but me and my young man. He takes me over the water, he takes me over the sea, and he buys me cups and saucers and takes me out to tea.
My mother says that I never should play with the gypsies in the wood. That's a very funny thing to say, cos there are no gypsies round our way.
Tin tin tan, I'm a looking bally sad. He a fled, and a fled, doing very bad. Tin tin tan, a man got a shutty shop. Tin tin tan, a man chop chop chop.
Early in the morning, early in the morning, early in the morning, before the break of day.
Upon Haley's proud heights, as the plover skunked on the moorland, and southward the cuckoo was taking his flight, and the corncrake was deep in the ground. A swallow and swift were aloft in the air, and the starling was feeding her young. Milkmaid was tending her cattle with care, and the haymakers cheerfully sung. The maidens of Burnley in satin or silk are pretty, I freely confess, but give me the maid who is neatly arrayed in a beautiful calico dress.
You may praise the Italian ladies in Ben and the maidens of France or Peru, or worship the languishing beauties of Spain and the blushing Circassians too. But she whom I love has an eye like a sloe, and her cheeks are like roses in June. So graceful each step as she trips like a doe, and her ruby red lips are in June.
The maidens of Bernie in satin or silk are pretty, I freely confess. But give me the maid who is neatly arrayed in a beautiful calico dress. Should fortune or friendship impel me to roam, or a thirst after changes constrain, I'd still call the banks of Old Healy my home, and I'd sing of its beauties again. Sweet gardens of roses or art-cultured bowers may delight a poor soul to possess. But give me Old Healy bedecked with wildflowers and the maid in the calico dress. The maidens of Burnley in satin or silk are pretty, I freely confess. But give me the maid who is neatly arrayed in a beautiful calico dress.
There's a cosy little spot and all lies just inside a boughton, whose praises I will sing to you in rhyme. Where lives me dear old grandad and me granny too, God bless them, and mony hour I've spent there in me time. They have a little garden and a slap up little greenhouse, where grandad passes mony hour away. He's happy and contented among his plants of flowers, and if I should pop in, he's sure to say,
"Hey man, I'm fain to see this city down. I'm as fain as if thou'd give me half a crown. Now thou mun go away, thou mun stop and I'll detay. I'm greatly fain to see this city down."
There's nowt in dear out spot but what I love as well as can be. There's thou case clock that stands right up to wall. There's thou couch cheer where grandad lies him down and has a snooze on. The spindle backed out rocking cheer and all. In thou three cornered cupboard, what me granny thinks at world on, lies relics of her childhood's happy days. I love old lock, front bread fleck, tut pot dogs that stand on drawers, and it does me good to hear me grandad say,
"In one I'm fain to see this city down. I'm as fain as if thou'd give me half a crown. Now thou mun go away, thou must stop and I'll detay. I'm greatly fain to see this city down."
I think we more to lesson learn from this outburst so humble, and try like them to lead an honest life. And if we do, I'm sure we's all be better able to jog along through this world's current strife. And if we're ever tempted to be selfish and hard-hearted, let's throw these nasty feelings clean away. Let's try to do to others as we'd have them do to us, and remember what me grandad used to say. In all I'm fain to see this city down, I'm as fain as if I'd give me half a crown. Now the mullen go away, the mun stop and all the day, I'm greatly fain to see this city down.
I was there, so were you, the mayor and the vicar, all the council too, with the wives and ladies on full view, the night John Willie took his ferret to a do. He slipped his lead with some butter from the sauce, he patterned all the table with his dirty little paws. Oh, said the vicar's wife, this rabbit isn't dead, as he danced a little jig around the hat upon her head. Oh, I was there, so were you, the mayor and the vicar, all the council too, with the wives and ladies on full view, the night John Willie took his ferret to a do. He ran down her collar and down the front he tore, he wriggled down her knicker leg and danced upon the floor. Oh, said the vicar, that's a sewer rat, I'm sure. Well, if that's the case, his wife replied, I wish we had some more. Oh, I was there, so were you, the mayor and the vicar, all the council too, with the wives and ladies on full view, the night John Willie took his ferret to a do. He ran through the soup and he nibbled at the peas, he dribbled all the gravy down the mare's knocking knees, and then he quenched his ferret's thirst with half a pint of shandy, and then relieved his little self in Mrs. Briley's brandy. Oh, I was there, so were you, the mayor and the vicar, all the council too, with the wives and ladies on full view, the night John Willie took his ferret to a do. Well, the ladies left their tables and began to dance with fright. They shouted out in panic at the little ferret's sight. He nibbled at their stockings and he tickled all their knees, and the vicar's wife kept shouting, give me some of that, please. Oh, I was there, so were you, the mayor and the vicar, all the council too, with the wives and ladies on full view, the night John Willie took his ferret to a do. He ran up and down the curtains and he swam about the punch, he herded all the ladies in a corner in a bunch, and just to end the escapade, he did a little quickie. He ran up the speaker's dinner suit and nibbled at his collar. Oh, I was there, so were you, the mayor and the vicar, all the council too, with the wives and ladies on full view, the night John Willie took his ferret to a do. Well, they caught the little fella and they put him in a box, they give him anaesthetic from the vicar's woolly socks, they sang him Annie Laurie in the mayor's own car, and then they got him back as fast as hell to John Willie's pen. Oh, I was there, so were you, the mayor and the vicar, all the council too, with the wives and ladies on full view, the night John Willie took his ferret to a do.
It was smashing when our dad come home after 2-3 pints at local. He'd sit in the armchair next to the fire, all eloquent and vocal. Then talk for hours on First World War, of Tommy's dead and gone. We duck with him as shells whiz past, rejoice at battles won. And walk through trenches thick with mud, learn words like comrade. So, on all Sundays came the cry, show us the medals, Dad. He'd keep 5 of them in a box. He'd hand one to each son. 5 pairs of hands caressed him as he described each one. That's where my leg get done, he'd say. Them flaming jury snipers. Jackie Ball get killed same day in a place as we call Wipers. He were nobbled 17, he'd sigh. A strapping Billings lad. Who was often sadder after saying, show us the medals, Dad. Mind you, his humour were a treat. It weren't all death and shells. He told us belting yarns about yon famous Dardanelles. One cow day he copped a German. Ah, cop mittens, he cried. Dad, lucky, I've no gloves none out. Our shivering Dad replied. I thought as he said mittens, Dad explained. We laughed like mad. He told it every time we said, show us the medals, Dad. Him and Harry Waterworth pinched a pig one night. We get fed up of eating rats, it's time we had a treat, and we gasped, rats. And he'd say, aye, get this cenobet on. We chased it all round Flanders fields until it geet a sweat up. A battalion dipped their bread in it. It didn't taste so bad. Aye, tears and laughter all as followed. Show us the medals, Dad. Though chap died a few months back, lads didn't scry without. He'd be with Jack and Harry, talking army days, no doubt. Our mam give us a medal each. We cherish them with pride. By God, when she bequeathed them, that's when we really cried. The reeds and medals auction now, for paltry sums it's sad. The card was selling memories, nay. We'll keep the medals. I miss thee, Sarah. Memories pass time away, but dunna ease this pain. And on rheumatic knees I pray, rest peaceful. Them awkward words like, I love thee, yeah, I couldn't speak, I'd sooner dee. I weren't that sort of chap, but see, I'm glad I wed thee. I love thee, I can say it there, but pity is as thou ain't here. It's easy sitting in this chair, I wish I'd towed thee. Slop stones piled with dirty plates, it's months since I black-leaded great. No donkey stone on't step out, mate, I've lost all interest. I used come one with bloodshot eyes. From supping ale I'd tell thee lies about where I'd been, then push thee pies up table. They'd look hurt, but still they didn't nag me, lass. No moan, I kept thee short of brass. I wouldn't raise another glass if it'd bring thee back. If thou could warm me bed out then, and let me stroke the air again, and kiss the pain away, but then what's use of wishing? I stirs at fire, I'm all red-eyed, but not from ale, from tears that's dried. I've scriked, I've ne'er moved outside,
I wish I could join thee. A favour, Sarah, if thou con. It's none deserved, but grant just one. If good Lord sends for me up yon, wait up for me.
When I receive me orders to go to the war and battle, it nearly broke me heart to leave me wife, me farm, me cattle. But when your country needs you so, oh, don't you know you've got to go? Oh, when your country needs you so, oh, don't you know you've got to go? They give me an enormous gun, an helmet and a dagger, I were presented with me army coat, so heavy it made me stagger. And I had to stand up straight as the post on the barrack gate. Oh, I had to stand up straight as the post on the barrack gate. I got no sleep for nights on end, they said I were a sentry. Had to walk up and down with a gun on me arm and frighten the local gentry. Each time I heard a tomcat purr, I had to shout, "Halt! Who goes there?" Each time I heard a tomcat purr, I had to shout, "Halt! Who goes there?" They took me to an enormous plain, they call it a field of battle. Guns were booming, daggers shining, men were dying, oh how fatal. Oh, I couldn't have given a damn, I threw in me gun and I upped and ran. Oh, I couldn't have given a damn, I threw in me gun, and here I am.
Bob Balloons was the landlord in the outring of bells, with his wife and their son, Gormless John. In the daytime, his wife tended cattle round back, and at the evenings with John waited on. And at the evenings with John waited on.
in a sing-song at Nate's John play piano a bit. They were lazy but by were fouls. We will that follow me, or shall I follow thee? And anyway each took his course. And anyway each took his course. John was sent off to market, be bought for a cow, and on his way into the town, met a woman called Annie, her blondie to some, and he took her to sup at the Crown. And he took her to sup at the Crown. Well, he wined her and dined her, and he took her to Fur, where they cocked on to all of the Rhine. Then they ate sugar, bunnies, black peas and the like, and he saw the fat lady beside. And he saw the fat lady beside. The coconut she eyes won a rag doll for her. Then John said, let's walk down to Wood. I will if thou only behave, says Anne. Thou'll be upset, me lass, if I shun. Thou'll be upset, me lass, if I shun. Later on, John jumped up on recalling his chore. He'll kill me, I've spent all his brass. He's no angel, his self whispered Anne in his ear. With that barmaid, he's flattened some grass. With that barmaid, he's flattened some grass. Where's the cow, Bob did ask. Now tink cowline, said John. Where's me brass then, asked father to son. About this here dog, it's a dog what can talk. Now come on, lad, let's have less of fun. Now come on, lad, let's have less of fun. It's true as I'm here, it'd be good for trade. That's weak in the bond, says his dad. If there's bout it, where is it, this miracle pup? Our coming to that, said the land. Our coming to that, said the land. Coming on Bit Canal, our chatting to dog, and it asked me where it would abide. I said, ring a bells, it said Bob Balloon's pub. Does he still have that red head on sign? Does he still have that red head on sign? You could hear a pin drop on Bob's face, it just fell. And he said, well, lad, what did they do? I drop kicked the bugger straight into canal to save it embarrassing you. To save it embarrassing you. That did reek, lad, said Bobby Balloons.
To the Ribble I went one morn, way a fishing friend called John, intending for to do a bit of angling. Soon whilst others had landed nout, John had it a tuttery trout. T'others sat their greedy eyes and lines a dangling. Soon he wasn't on his tod, he could hardly see his rod. For other people's lines around it swishing. Just because they'd landed nout and he'd pulled a couple out, everyone wanted to fish where he were fishing. If you're successful in your job, or if you make a couple of bob, keep a watch along the bank, don't get cops nodding.
for as sure as eggs are eggs, there'll be hundreds round your peg, and there won't be any room to get your rod in. If you have a good idea, impart it only to your dear friends and those who you would like to have a look in. For if you are too spurring with the sharks, you'll soon be shirring, and there'll not be space to cast your line and hook in. And when you have a bride proud and radiant by your side, and you catch the twinkling eyes of fellas wishing, well then stick to her like glue, and make sure she sticks to you. Don't let anybody fish where you are fishing.
Where is that youngster all forlorn who used to get up at break of morn, spend half a day working and half on a farm? Oh, little half-timer, it ne'er did him good, sighing and sobbing, he stuck out his chest like little cock-robin. But sitting in school is yet a'd keep nodding. Oh, little half-timer, he had no time to comb his locks for looking around to find his socks under his arm, his bread box. Oh, little half-timer, learning ways at fine trifold, of time the buttered roughest jokes, but just like a blotter whose lessons he'd soak. Oh, little half-timer, learning to tube, to fault and carry, discovering difference between stirring and tarry, theatred minder, playing how dare. Poor little half-timer, he thought her a felly when they sent him a brewing, but mind her and tell him, mind what thou'rt doing, and oft times his clogs would be his undoing. Oh, little half-timer, now they don't see no work till turn 15, and finer young childer and never been seen. Oh, what a difference there is between poor little half-timers.
Oh, pity me, my darling, it's pity me, I say, it's pity me, my darling, and carry me away.
Welcome all you weary factory girls, I love you, understand. I'm going to leave this factory and return to my own land. No more I'll leave my bobbins up, no more I'll take them down. No more I'll clean my dirty work, for I'm going out of town.
Pity me, my darling, it's pity me, I say. It's pity me, my darling, and carry me away.
For since they've taken our wages down to 9 shillings per week, if I cannot better wages make some other place I'll seek. 'Tis wonder how the masters can such machinery make, 1,000 wheels together roll without the least mistake.
Pity me, my darling, it's pity me, I say. It's pity me, my darling, and carry me away.
Prancer, tapping soles and clacking heels, jumping Jackie's best club dancer, her stepped out with jigs and reels, twisting, turning, pointing, prancing, while her fiddle sings away, later than a feather dancing on a breeze in month of May. Watch on childer clap together, keeping time to click and clack. Summer, winter, any weather, out they come to Jumpin' Jack. Carnivals can't do without him, churches want him for bazaars. Over 60s wait me about him, sooner him than tell he stars. Watch him go, ye gridley prancer, tapping toes and clacking heels. Jumping Jackie's best clog dancer, her steps out with jigs and reels, twisting, turning, pointing, prancing, while her fiddle sings away, lighter than a feather dancing on a breeze in month of May. Purr on purr, a clubs he's battered, still his pins are straight and true, as on day when first he clattered in new clubs when he were two. Jack lad, keep the toes it fettle, make our spirits gay and lead. Though the clogs are shod with metal, we find gold in them to feed. Watch him go, ye gridley prancer, tapping toes and clacking heels. Jumping Jackie's best clog dancer, stepped out with jigs and reels. Twisting, turning, pointing, prancing, while her fiddle sings away, lighter than a feather dancing on a breeze in month of May.